Some sources are better quality than others. Think of it as you might think of evidence in a criminal case. Eyewitness testimony is based on one person's account of what happened and is often unreliable. And fingerprints may use as few as 10 or 12 points of comparison. But the method of comparison is based on the scientific method. And DNA matching uses 26 points of comparison and is also based on the scientific method. Clearly, DNA is more reliable than fingerprints or eyewitness testimony. Now, I know I just simplified something that is really complex, and many more factors go into these judgments. But you get the idea. The same is true of information sources. There are many indicators that help determine the quality of information. Let's take a look at a few. What type of source did it come from? Magazine? Trade journal? Scholarly journal? Magazine articles may give information on scientific discoveries, but the information has been simplified and shortened to an eighth of a paragraph meant to be read by somebody with an eighth grade education. Trade journals are aimed at professionals within a discipline, but include news-type articles, interviews, and opinion pieces. Scholarly journals are more selective in what they publish and often include research articles that are the result of experiments conducted using the scientific method. Is it peer-reviewed? Whether or not research articles are reviewed by other experts in the field is an indicator, because information reviewed by other experts is more reliable than information not reviewed by other experts. What author information is given? Look for the credentials of the authors and their institutional affiliations. Are the authors practitioners? Do they have PhDs? Are the authors affiliated with research institutions? Now, don't get me wrong here. I'm not trying to be a snob. Practitioners are on the front lines and know what's going on. But generally, it is people with advanced degrees and who are affiliated with research institutions that have the support and the advanced statistical and methodology knowledge to set up quality research studies. What type of article is it? Expert opinion or research study? If it is a research study, is it primary or secondary research? Remember that secondary research articles are those that compare and contrast several research articles on the same topic, so it increases the strength of the conclusions. If the article is from a primary research study, how was it performed? What numbers of subjects were included in the study? Let's look at an example for this one. Cassie is a physical education teacher with 15 years of experience, and in that experience, teaching junior high students, Cassie has noted that the use of pedometers with 7th and 8th graders increases the amount of exercise overall that the children do each day. Cassie decides to perform an experiment between two of her gym classes at the junior high school. One class will be the control group, and the other class will get pedometers, and she will determine a measure to see if either group of students increases their exercise levels. This is basically a pilot study, with a small sample group including 40 children. Cassie then talks to a professor at a nearby university, and they set up a larger research study that includes 20 classrooms throughout the entire school district. They now have 400 participants. It is a larger participant pool, but the school district is fairly homogeneous. More experts and researchers get involved, and a statewide study is conducted that includes 200 classrooms, or roughly 4,000 students. But again, this study was only conducted statewide, and therefore the results can only be generalized to the people in that state. So the next step would be a research study that is nationwide that will give the researchers data with the full diversity of the nation. So why, if a nationwide study is better, would anyone look at an expert opinion or a pilot study for evidence? Because sometimes that's all there is. Conducting a nationwide study takes a lot of time, effort, and money, and just isn't possible all the time. All evidence is useful, but when practitioners need to make decisions, they need to weigh the type of evidence that they found.